19-year-old Alex Sekizivo is currently nursing wounds on his head after thugs hit him with a hammer. This incident, which underscores a sharp rise in such crimes, happened on the 11th April near Namirembe Cathedral.
Nanga awo wanko vila awo nyonda awo sategeo. Kwa nga utuwa ini yanga wako wataku gadi. Nga wagamba. Nyegwe nupichi tuja agala.
Sekizivo is among the few like a border riders who has lived to relay the harrowing tale.
Kwa liko mutono tono. Nekuwira kono umunene. Nomunene nga. Nomunene nene. Kwa hii yali asembine mavega.
Many of his colleagues have been gruesomely murdered, especially in the dark of the night. At the time of the attack, his colleagues rushed him to the hospital and were able to arrest a suspect who was still armed with a hammer. The suspected iron bar hitman is identified as Mudiri Ndugude and was held at Old Kampala Police Station.
Kateimbwa was arrested by a mob.
However, to the shock of the complainants, he was let off the hook amidst allegations that a senior police officer at this station was given a dangling carrot of 5 million shillings.
They did not think about the life of those people who have been hammered.
NTV has obtained a telephone conversation between a private investigator and a suspect. In the interview, the suspect, who falsely believes he is speaking to an acquaintance, reveals how he sold his car to wriggle his way out of sales.
Hey.
But police has denied the bribery allegations, claiming the suspect was raised on medical grounds.
He was beaten by the mob. Actually, he survived narrowly. It is police which saved him. Even we who are not medical personnel, you could see that he was not okay. He was urinating blood. It is not true. They want to portray the staff of this station as corrupt as what. That is not true. We are doing our work professionally.
He was arrested, the motorcycle recovered. Now, how could he afford to raise a whole 5 million Uganda shillings? Now, we have always indicated, we have seen us trumping our officers.
Mzee Phillips Katabarwa, a retired civil servant who is now a private investigator, claims the force is littered with rogue elements who collaborate with thugs.
I'm telling you, some police officers, especially in the CID, are cooperating with the thugs.
Any Ugandan is free to go to Bukoto at PSU headquarters and complain.
Now, above the district offices, we have the regional offices, and we have always emphasized this to the members of the public.
Recently, the embattled Nansana Police Post Officer in charge, Ahmed Kirumira, spilled the beans. He accused his colleagues of working with criminals.
I know them. I know what they do. I have been dealing with them, arresting them, in and out, orders from above, orders from heaven, orders from hell.
Kirumira has since then been suspended on allegation of receiving a bribe, an accusation he says was orchestrated by mafia to bring him down.
If they want, they should make a secret investigation and interview police officers who have been victims of PSU. Many of them are corrupt.
Whether with or without Kirumira, the policing activities in Nansana will continue.
NTV has learned that in light of such damaging claims for an institution whose public approval ratings continue to languish in the basement, police recently called a crisis meeting.
Now, the matters of Mr. Kirumira have been reviewed by the Inspector General of Police and have been transferred from the Professional Standard Unit to the Directorate of Human Rights and Legal Services.
The Uganda Police Force has been ranked amongst the most corrupt institutions in the country. Records at the Professional Standard Unit show that a total of 2,657 cases were registered against police officers last year alone. Jjingo Francis, NTV.